Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. In this video, we will discuss Class 10 Mathematics Chapter 3 Pair of Linear Equations in Two Variables. Exercise 3.3 Question Number 3 Solution. Form the pair of linear equations for the following problems and find their solution by substitution method. In this question, there are 6 sub-questions. Sub-question 1, the difference between two numbers is 26 and one number is 3 times the other. Find them. So here we need to find the numbers. They have given this condition, the difference between two numbers is 26 and one number is 3 times the other. So we need to find the numbers as we don't know anything regarding the numbers here. So now let us take that the largest number is x and the smallest number is y. So here we are taking the value in such a way that x is greater than y. Here x is the larger number and y is the smaller number. We need to find out the exact value of this x and y. Now let us apply this situation. They have given the difference between two numbers is 26. Whenever we find a difference, generally we consider the larger number and then we consider the smaller number. So here the larger number is x, smaller is y. That means we can write the difference between these two numbers as x minus y. So they have given the difference between two numbers is 26. So we can have an equation x minus y is equal to 26. Now let us name this as equation number 1. Then they have given one number is 3 times the other number. So one number is 3 times the other number means here, see, we have taken the larger number as x. So 3 times of the other number means from that we can make out that this number is the largest number and this number is the smallest number. Because the first number is here larger than the second number 3 times of the other number, that they have given that condition already. So from this we can make out that here the first number is the larger number which we have taken as x and the next number is the smaller number, that is y. So 3 times the other number, that means x is equal to 3y. Now let us name this as equation number 2. Now here we got two equations 1 and 2. So you can apply here the substitution method. In the substitution method, in the first step, we are finding the value of the variable. But here you can observe in equation 2, directly we have the value. So that value directly you can write here, x is equal to 3y. Next, in the second step of the substitution, you have to put this value in any one of these equations. That means this value I'm now substituting in this equation because here we got this value from this equation 2. So that's why substituting this x value in equation 1. Then let us see what happens. See, we have equation 1, x minus y is equal to 26. Here you put x is equal to 3y. So we get 3y minus y is equal to 26. 3y minus y gives 2y. 2y is equal to 26. Y is equal to 26 divided by 2. So y is equal to 13. Now we got the value of one variable. You substitute this value in this equation. That is, generally in the substitution method, we substitute this value in equation 3. But in our case, equation 2 as well as equation 3, both are one and the same. So here we have taken the same value. So that's why now you substitute this y value in equation 2. So we have x is equal to 3y. Put here y is equal to 13. So x is equal to 3 into 13. That is, x is equal to 39. So here we got the x value 39 and y value as 13. Then at the beginning, see, we have taken x as the largest number and y as the smallest number. So we got the answer here. Larger number x is equal to 39 and smaller number y is equal to 13. So this is the final answer of this sub-question 1. Second sub-question, under question number 3, the larger of two supplementary angles exceeds the smaller by 18 degrees, find them. So here we need to find the angles. See, they have mentioned something regarding supplementary angles. First, let us see what are supplementary angles. The supplementary angles means if you find the sum of two angles, then that should give you the answer 180 degree. For example, see here we have a one pair of angle, that is one is 60 degree and 120 degree. These two are placed on this particular line. So here you can observe that the angle DBC or CBD is equal to 120 degree and the angle ABD is equal to 60 degree. But if I add these two angles, then I get 180 degree. So these type of angles are known as supplementary angles. So in the case of supplementary angles, we have two angles and when we add those two angles, we get the sum as 180 degree. So now see in the question they have asked us to find the angles, supplementary angles we need to find out. That means two angles we need to find out. So right now we don't know the answer. So that's why let us take the larger angle as X and the smaller angle as Y. Then we know that from the definition of the supplementary angle, the sum is always equal to 180 degree. So we have taken these two as supplementary angle. So from the definition of supplementary angles, now we can write X plus Y is equal to 180 degree. Next, see in the question they have given, the larger of two supplementary angles exceeds the smaller by 18. The larger of two supplementary angles. See, we have taken the larger as X. So, X is equal to exceeds the smaller by 18. That means this 18 you have to add to the smaller angle. See, smaller angle we have taken as Y. So, Y plus 18 or 18 plus Y. X is equal to Y plus 18. So, if you take this to this side, we have X minus Y is equal to 18. Now, we got the second equation. So, here we have the first equation, that is from the definition of the supplementary angle. And this we got from this particular sentence. So we have here two equation. So as we have now two equation, you can apply the substitution method. The first step of the substitution method is we need to find the value of the variable by taking any one of these two equations. So here I feel this one as a simple equation. So I am taking here X minus Y is equal to 18. If I move this value to this side, then we get X is equal to Y plus 18. Now let us name this as equation 3 and this value you substitute in other equation. So here we have the remaining equation 1 because we have taken this equation and we got this value. So another equation remaining is this one. So you substitute this X value in this equation. So substituting X in equation 1. So we have equation 1, X plus Y is equal to 180 degree. Here you put X is equal to Y plus 18. Then we have plus Y is equal to 180. Then Y plus Y, 2Y is equal to, take this 18 to this side, that is converted into minus 18. So 2Y is equal to 180 minus 18. 2Y is equal to 162, Y is equal to 162 divided by 2, that gives the answer 81. Y is equal to 81. Next in the third step, this value you need to substitute in the third equation, which we got from step 1. So this is our third equation. So in this equation, you substitute this value. X is equal to Y plus 18. This is our third equation. Here you put the Y value as 81. So X is equal to 81 plus 18 gives X is equal to 99. So the answer is X is equal to 99 and Y is equal to 81. And here at the beginning, we have taken X as larger angle and Y as smaller angle. So finally, we can write the solution. Larger angle X is equal to 99, smaller angle Y is equal to 81. And you can observe here, if I add these two angles, 99 plus 81 if I do, then I get the answer 180 degree. So these two angles are nothing but the supplementary angles. This is about sub-question 2. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Also click the bell icon to get regular notification. Thanks for watching.